and gentlemen, welcome inside George's Pond and Hirsch Coliseum. It's time for Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey as they open up this two-game series against the Odessa Jackalopes. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Chet Yoder, the voice of the Mudbugs, as the Bugs get ready for this first game of this two-game series against the Odessa Jackalopes here at George's Pond and Hirsch Coliseum. It's Halloween slash Oktoberfest-themed weekend, so lots of scary and spooky stuff will be surrounding the bowl, and will be part of our theme this weekend as the Mudbugs look to build off a nice 4-3 win they had last Saturday against the Oklahoma Warriors, and really kind of a seesaw wild third period that saw Logan Gotinski score a pair of goals along with Garrett Steele sandwiched in between all of that. So the Bugs were able to come away with a 4-3 victory, and they are now 2-4-2 on the season. And that was their first home win of the season as they take on a struggling Odessa Jackalope squad that is 1-4-1 with 3 points. The Mudbugs in sixth place, the Odessa Jackalopes in the bottom of the basement at eighth place in the South Division. In first place is New Mexico at 13 points, Amarillo's in second with 12 points along with Lone Star at 12 points, Oklahoma and El Paso both tied with 10 points on the season. We'll talk to Mudbugs head coach Jason Soupy Campbell after these messages. It's the Mudbugs and the Jackalopes, game one of this two-game series here, as we'll have more after these messages as we count down to the 7-11 Margaritaville start time. And this is the Landers Dodge Jeep Chrysler and Ram pregame show. You're listening to Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
As a business owner, you know it's important to stay ahead of your competition to succeed. One dishonest employee providing poor customer service can send your business to the penalty box. DeFatta & Associates has over 20 years of investigative experience that can help you monitor employees and investigate losses that may be keeping you from reaching your goals. Whether you need GPS tracking, investigative shopping, integrity testing, or you're experiencing losses caused by theft, DeFatta & Associates can help. Give them a call at 318-635-9944 or check out their website at DeFattaPI.com for more information.
Sterling Dental Center is a proud partner of the Shreveport Mudbugs. I'm Dr. Emil Janu, and my experienced staff and I will handle all your dental needs, from routine cleanings, x-rays, cavities, toothaches, and more, with the best and safest treatment out there. We are a family here at Sterling Dental Center, and we treat our patients like family. We welcome many forms of insurance. Come get your next dental appointment at Sterling Dental Center in Shreveport by calling 318-688-1040 or logging on to sterlingdentalshreveport.com.
Welcome back into the Landers Dodge Jeep Chrysler and Ram pregame show. Game one of this two-game series between the Mudbugs and the Odessa Jackalopes. We're joined by Mudbugs head coach Jason Soupy Campbell. And coach, last Saturday, obviously a much-needed win for your team. First home win of the season. A wild and crazy third period, but one that maybe showed a little character from your team for the first time this season?
Yeah, well, I mean, even the night before, you know, them fighting back and scoring with 0 seconds left on the clock, you know, it just, these guys are a resilient group. They won't stop working, and that's the one thing we'll find with this entire group. They're going to play hard, and, up to that point, we were just struggling putting points up on the board, and we kind of broke out in the third period, and we scored some timely goals. You know, it was one of those situations where it looked like we wanted to win, then we looked like we wanted to give it away, then it looked like we wanted to win, then give it away, and ultimately we got the last goal. So, fortunate for us, we had a big win. Just hopefully we can learn from that win. You know, I felt like we were kind of picking up some pace from the losses that we were having. We were kind of learning through those hard times. Now hopefully we can learn through a win and continue learning how to be consistent winners.
Did it feel extra nice to give Tommy Aiken that win? It felt like maybe he was owed a couple of wins this season of how good he's been in net. And for him to obviously have a big smile on his face, that must have been nice.
Yeah, it's a huge, huge deal for him. Just, he should be confident with the way he's played. But, you know, when you're not winning the game, it does just kind of give you a little bit of a punch in the gut. You know, like, dang it, we were so close and still didn't get the win, you know. But yeah, he definitely deserved that. So I'm glad we were able to put the goals up for him to be able to win that one.
Of course, news this week. Can you talk about the moves? Of course, Evan Mitchell, Mac Taylor, and Matt Cole no longer part of this team. Talk about where they've gone.
Yeah, Evan's going to the AJ Blackfalds, and it's just a situation where there's a good opportunity there for him. And I mean, he was doing well here. There's it's hard for people to understand why trades are made or the behind the scenes of trades and stuff like that. And there was no hard feelings with this move at all. You know, we love Evan Mitchell. We think he's a great hockey player. He's a great leader off of the ice, and he's going to bring a lot to that team in the AJ. What that leaves us with here is an opportunity for somebody else to try to pick up where he left off and grow into a leader that we need and grow into a great player that we need. So great opportunity for Mitchie moving on, and great opportunity for younger players or other players in general to kind of step up and fill that role. And it really goes for the same with Cole. You know, Matt did an excellent job for us. He's a workhorse and can really play anywhere throughout your lineup, and he's going to complement any team where he ends up. We don't know where he's going just yet, but we obviously wish him the best, and he did a great job while he was here. But again, another opportunity for a player that's still here to step up and try to fill those shoes, and hopefully we have somebody that can do it. And then with Mac, he's a younger player, just he hadn't been able to get the opportunity that he maybe deserved or was looking for here. So there is an opportunity for him in the SJHL, and he's going to go do that in Estevan, and I hope that opportunity presents itself well for him, because again, he's a great kid with huge upside. He just didn't get the opportunity that he was kind of looking for that we could provide here. So we wish them all the best, and moving forward, we're going to keep an eye on them as usual. You know, you get connected with these guys, and you really grow to love them as people, and respect what they can bring to the game. And we're going to follow them, that's for sure. And but I'm also really looking forward to seeing how the guys that are remaining here kind of jump in and fill these roles.
The big news, of course, tonight, Simo Buschler makes his return after day two of starting of training camp when he got hurt with his lower body injury. I guess it couldn't have started out any more disastrously for him. But he's been, of course, anxiously, patiently awaiting his turn. Lots of work with Amy Baker, our beloved athletic trainer. I mean, just talk about where this young man is. Obviously, you were excited about what you saw from him last year, and I think he was peaking at the end of last year, winning four of his five starts, and he also won the playoff game last year against Lone Star. So, boy, I mean, it's got to be an exciting feeling for him and the team.
Yeah, he's pretty fired up, and you know, when he was coming back to training camp, we were all excited to see him, you know, and see what he was going to bring to the table. And unfortunately, the injury happened. So, but yeah, he's excited, but he's calm, and he's ready. He looks poised, and he's ready to go. And we're excited for him. And you know, hopefully, he can just take off from where he left off last year. He's been a true professional through this whole ordeal. You know, he wants to play, and he's been dying to play, but when your body's just not letting you do it, he was really being as patient as he possibly could to make sure he was 100% ready to go, not only physically, but you know, from a conditioning standpoint and mentally prepared to go. So we feel like the time is now, and we're fired up to see him in between the pipes tonight.
What do we know about this Odessa Jackalopes team? Because as we know of years past, they've always given the Mudbugs trouble. Mudbugs were 3-5 against them last season. Scott Durr, now second year head coach here at the Jacks. We know him with his success at Fairbanks. Talk about what this Jackalopes team presents.
They look like they play fast. You know, they've got some good shooters again, and you know, they've made a couple moves here recently with trades and stuff like that as well. So injecting a little something new into their lineup again. Their record isn't great, just like ours. But again, that doesn't mean anything to me. It never does, never will. It's going to be a battle every single night. So I know Scotty's going to have them going over there, and we just got to make sure our guys are ready to go off the hop of the puck, because both teams are going to be hungry for a big win.
What do you need to see in the first period from your team?
I just want to see us play simple, hard, and disciplined. That's it. Just get pucks deep and go in and finish hits when the time is right, and make sure we're responsible with the puck, just not turning it over and allowing these guys to come at us with speed all night long. And so as far as I'm concerned, if we can win a faceoff, get it deep, and get on our forecheck right off the hop, that's a good start for me.
Coach, thanks for the time, and good luck tonight.
Thank you, Chet Yoder.
We'll have more after these messages here on the Landers Dodge Jeep Chrysler and Ram pregame show. You're listening to Shreveport Mudbucks Hockey.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs.
Welcome back into George's Pond at Hirsch Coliseum. Now time for the Whataburger starting lineups. First for the Odessa Jackalopes. Head coach by Scott Durr, assistant coach Chris Francis, and goalie coach Colin Grubb. At left wing, number 16, Adam Armijo. At center will be number 27, Justin Hughes. And on the right wing will be number 21, John Purdian. Defensively for the Jacks, it'll be number 29, Nate Boak, and number 7, Trevor Mitchell. And making the first start in net for Odessa will be number 33, Greg Arozzo. The Whataburger starting lineups for the Shreveport Mudbugs, head coach by Jason Soupy Campbell in his fifth year as the bench boss. Associate head coach Michael Hill, goalie coach Rich Perrant, and honorary assistant Chris Lane. At left wing will be number 23, Ryan Burke. At center will be number 12, Hayden Nickel. And on the right wing will be number 18, Garrett Steele. Defensively for the Bugs, it'll be number 6, Maxim Sushinsky. And number 5, Alex Park. And making his return in net after a long rehab after a lower body injury suffered. Glad to have him back from Saint-Laurent, Montreal. Number 44, Simon Bushler, and the numbers on Bushler were very impressive, especially down the stretch. He won 4 of his last 5 starts, including a playoff win here in Shreveport in game number 3 of that Lone Star Series. The numbers were great down the stretch, like I said, 7-9-1 with a 2.68 goals against. He makes his first start after suffering a lower body injury in just day 2 of training camp. What a long road back to recovery. He changed the number. It's a new look, a new year for Simo Bushler, and we're glad to have him back between the pipes this evening. Those are your Whataburger starting lineups. Whataburger, just like you like it. Mudbugs Hockey Tonight brought to you by Porter's Industrial, delivering the difference in the Arklatex for over 20 years. Porter's Industrial strives with the utmost integrity to meet our customers' needs with quality uniform and facility services for your business. Mudbugs in their teal jerseys with the Mudbug head in front, the white letterings and numberings on the back. Odessa in their new red and black jerseys with the Odessa in front and the white numberings and letterings on the back. The Mudbugs will skate from left to right. Now he asks, do you please rise for hear me be for tonight's national anthem. The very lovely Miss Tiffany Schubert serenading us with another lovely edition of tonight's national anthem. Mudbugs ready to go against the Odessa Jackalopes. I want to thank all our 2022-2023 Mudbug Billet families for everything they do. Leanne and Brian Bechtel, Miss Harriet Boddy, Zach and Jordan Choate, Courtney and Jason Davis, Keith and Becca Gibb, Mr. Jim Hacker, Kristen and Jeremy Kennedy, Amanda and Drew Lewis, James and Amanda Meyer, Miss Karen Mitchell, our brilliant Mudbugs Billet coordinator, Sarah and Jason Morris, Martin and Collar Mueller, along with Chucky Landry and family, Ronnie and Bridget Peterson, Carl and Amanda Phillips, Heather and Mark Price, Bo and Lee Raines, Randy and Tanya Reeves, Casey Ryan and Dave Percotta, Trey and Elizabeth Simmons, Holland and Riley Spencer, Don and Janice Watt, Mark Weldon, and Beth and Mark Woods for all being proud billets of the Shreveport Mudbugs. We can't do it without you. Lots of eyes on Simo Buschler as he makes his first start between the pipes this season for the Mudbugs. Lots of patience from him, as Coach Subi described it in the Landers pregame show, and really not a lot of nerves. He's very relaxed, but of course very excited for this opportunity. This is an Odessa Jackalope team that has only won once in six games to begin the season. It is not too far off from the Mudbug struggles, as they have won twice in eight games. It'll be Nickel and Hughes for our Landers opening puck drop as we have hit the countdown marker to our Margaritaville 7-11 start time. Puck is dropped and battled and tied up and won there by Nickel. Play to the far side there. That's Sushinsky. He'll slide it back to Park off the stick of steel and direct it into the Odessa zone, and now flagged back out to center. Taken there by Sushinsky, now intercepted there by Hughes, and he'll drop it back to his blue line. He'll go cross ice to the near side there to Ormeo. Now through the slot, thrown across, quick shot, save made, rebound chance was shoveled out of trouble there by Nickel. That was a pad save along the right pad of Buschler as he came across the far post. There was a juicy rebound, but a good job there by Nickel to slap it out of play. Face off deep to the left of Buschler. So glad to say Buschler's name yet again. A big hello to his fine folks as they are tuned in, I'm sure, on the edge of their seats from Saint-Laurent, Montreal. Face off one there by the Bugs. Sushinski slaps it out of play, and we get another break in the action. You can get your season tickets now. It's not too late. Just give us a call at 318-636-7094 or log on to mudbugshockey.com. 2022-2023 season tickets are still available. There's still limited seats for the remainder of this season. Faceoff tied up. Looks like it's won there by the Bugs. Good job there by Nickel. Now tapped along the end boards, around to the near corner. Chopped at there by Steele, but he cannot get it out. Kept in there by Wojciechowski. Now behind the net to the far corner. Now just kind of threaded into that near corner. It's taken there by Tanyan Bajer. Bajer lined up with Ryan Kelly and Ryan Mansfield. Along the end boards, that's Sushinski. He'll knock it up ahead there to the captain, Steele. Thrown up ahead there to Burke. Good stretch pass. Burke now to the near half wall. He'll just shovel it in deep there for Nickel. Nickel behind the net. Couldn't grab it. Now off the near side. Banked up ahead there to Mansfield. He'll lumber his way into the zone. Good body positioning there by Zarski. It's now taken there by Haru, his roommate. And he'll just level it into the Odessa zone. Chopped up there by Haru. Chopped in deep behind the Jackalope zone behind Orozo. And a penalty coming up now to the Bugs. And that's how this game gets started. It's going against Gotinski. It's going to be a tripping infraction. And Gotinski's the guilty party. Boy, he's got that. You're going to call that look in the middle of in the first 2 minutes of this game. Gotinski looks a bit uneasy about the call, but he'll sit for two. Mudbugs PK, very good overall. They're sixth best in the league at 87.1%. Odessa Jackalope power play has been struggling. They're 25th, 3-for-23. First choice personnel penalty kill on the ice for Shreveport. Along to the far corner, that's Dane Hoyard. He'll play it back up top now. Far half wall play now. Back up top to Stacey. Stacey at the point. He'll go to the far side. Back to Stacey. Stacey thrown on toward the net. Blocker save made there by Buschler. And the puck now is slapped all the way down there by Goldie. Good job there by Goldie. A big hello to the Goldie family. Tune in tonight from Owen Sound, Ontario. Along to the far side. A little space here. Far circle. Quick shot. Shoveled out there by Buschler. And a shot there from the far circle there by Purdian. Puck now kind of pinballs around. And it'll come back out to center. Taken there by Stacey. He'll glide back to the near side there to Boak. Boak now along to the far side. A little space here for Purdy and thrown in front. It was tipped on its way through and went high of Buschler's cage. As Austin has it, he'll pin it along now along the end boards. Behind Buschler's cage, trying to kill off some more precious seconds there is Austin. And now we got a whistle as it looks like that puck got stuck along the end boards. 1:02 remaining on Gotinski's tripping infraction, the first power play of the game, which belongs to Odessa. I'm Chet Yoder coming to you live from George's Pond at Hirsch Coliseum. So glad to have you with us here on a comfortable Friday night here in Shreveport, Louisiana. Volkema to take the draw. Far circle. Face-off battle at tied up and won there by Odessa. That's Kelly. Kelly has it now. He'll drop it back far half wall. Working the zone there. Mansfield rips a shot. It goes wide of Buschler. Now Hughes dropped in deep there to Kelly. Kelly at the left point. He'll drop it back to Hughes. They work a cycle back up top to Kelly. Now they'll relay it back to the top of the point. Wojciechowski waits. He'll go to the right point. Waiting for it now. Thrown cross ice. Play to the near circle. That's Hughes back up top to Wojciechowski. Wojciechowski now far side to Mansfield. Thrown in front. Pat save. Rebound chance. Buschler's got it. Right between the pads. Big time stop along the short side there by Buschler. And boy, he's getting tested early. But he's able to swallow it up nicely and keep it out with 28 seconds remaining on Gotinski's tripping infraction. Face off deep. Left wing circle, one there by the Bugs, and Haru hammered off the near side, boards all the way down. Bushler getting tested early. That might be a good thing for him just to get him loose. Nickel now will throw it back to Haru, and they'll kill off some more precious seconds as Odessa wants to get a line change. Haru waits in front of Bushler. He just gallops, and now he'll just wing it all the way down. And that'll do it for the first power play of the night for the Jacks. They're 0-for-1. No score, 3.5 gone by in the early stages. Off the stick of Finn, he'll flip it in there for Mansfield. Along to the near corner, check that, that was William Marshall. Now to the near corner, taken away there by Goldie, up ahead there to Gotinski. He'll nudge it back out to center. Far side, puck just golfed in along the far side there by Samuel Skilstead. And now far side, that's Mack. He'll whack it off the far side boards all the way down. We got an icing infraction, and now, wait a minute here. No, just an icing on the Bugs. And it is a not-so-favorable start for the two-time Robbie Cup champs. Almost 4 minutes gone by here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period. Face-off battle at one there by the Bugs. Haru off the near side boards. Kept in there by Hoyard along to the far side. Hoyard's going to grab it now. He'll drop it off now. Far circle. Good stick now. Play to the left point. Handle there. Armijo, a shot off the, I believe, the skate of Austin. That's Josh Austin. And it went wide of Bushler. Now to the point. Odessa dictates the play again. They'll now just kind of tap it in. Zarski's got it. Zarski along the near side boards off the stick of Mack. Mudbugs can't clear. Now far circle, quick shot, save made there by Bushler. As a save was made off of a shot of Blake Arneson from the far circle. First period tonight brought to you by Generational Financial Advisors. For more information on planning your life's needs from college to retirement, you can call Ms. Janice Wan at 318-219-4188 or log on to gfapartners.com. 4:31 gone by here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period. Still no score in the early stages. Nickel to take the draw from the far circle. Face-off battle at tied up one there by Nickel again. They'll roulette wheel this off the near side boards, off the stick of steel, back out to center. Burke on pursuit, getting help there by Nickel, but slapped back out to center as Park will just pile drive it back into the Odessa zone. Now thrown up the middle, taken away there by Nickel. Nickel now will pivot back, left point, thrown across now, near circle, Burke drop back, quick shot, score! It's Danziger! Danziger threw it from the right point. It might have been tipped in front off the stick of steel. Mudbugs won, Jacks nothing. And I believe Steele gets the goal off the shot from Danziger at the point. And Danziger and Steele know how to get this party started. Shreveport 1, Odessa nothing. 4:57 into this baby. And big time elation from number four, the big 6'6", 235-pounder from Potomac, Maryland. Oh, they would love to get Steele going. He's been playing great hockey. They want to get some goals, and I know he does too, working very hard on his game and being a better leader every day. 4:57 It is Steele's officially. Now thrown toward the net. That was Gotinski. He got blocked. Steele from Danziger and Ryan Burke at 4:57. And now back the other way. Quick shot. Pad save made there by Bushler. steals third of the season. Might have hit off the knee of Steele looking at the replay. And another shot there. Shoulder save made there by Arozzo from a shot from the far corner there by Mack. And for the second time, or second game in a row, the Mudbugs grabbed the game's first goal. That's got to feel good. Off the near side. Now played back behind the Jacks net. Far side. A play to the near side, and the puck is just slapped in there by Kelly. Off the far side. On that right point there by Wojciechowski got blocked. Now, that is Lavassier who ladled one toward the center, now played back into the Bug zone. Now behind the Bug's net, Odessa pushing here. Play to the left point, settled down. Waiting, thrown toward the net there by Arneson, got blocked in front. Arneson's got it near half wall. Quick shot tipped on its way through. Pad save and diving on the hot potato. There is Buschler. Boy, he has been under duress for the first 6:31 of this game. One of our fans, Mr. Donovan Ducote, nicknamed Garrett Steele the Animal in reference to the Legion of Doom, Hawk and Animal, for anybody that gets that reference. A 1-0 Mudbugs lead. Big hello goes out to some fine folks. And our next whistle, Miller. Goes around to the far side there to Volkema. Volkema toward the net as he fired one. Left pad save. Kept in there by Danziger. Spun around now. Kept in there. Tied up there was Morris. He kicks it along now along behind the net. Along to that far corner. Handled there by Morris. Morris has it. Morris dropped off there to Zarski. Zarski now down low as a blue man. A blue liner, rather. Now to the right point, Danziger trying to work it in deep. It got blocked, played back out to center there by Good. That's Emerson Good. Now bodied in to the Mudbug zone behind the Bug's net. Felt like most of the puck has been in the Bug zone. Intercepted there by Steele on a shot there by Wojciechowski. Ah, that pass got broken up. Far side, Volkema just wants to drop it back to Zarski. Zarski has it. Stretch feed up ahead there to Nickel, thrown toward the net. Right pad save made there by Arozzo. Off the near side and taken there by Park, and he'll slice it back in. And now Steele, shot toward the net, got blocked in front there by Hughes. Now along the inboards, trying to stay with it there. Wraparound chance. Oh, boy, save made there by Arozzo as Nickel was looking for one. Now around the near side, driving the net. Quick shot, might have hit the post. That was Purdy, and or might have fought off some kind of piece of iron and maybe a piece of the armor of Buschler, or some people like to call it body armor. Behind Buschler's nine boards, back into the Odessa zone, off the stick of Mansfield. He's got it. He'll broom it into the far corner. Handled there by Kelly, getting a hard hit along the back. Chasing after it, grinding it out there as Goldie worked back out. Mudbugs battling here. Little space now. Far half wall. And now puck broken up, and Gotinski wants to now take it back out. Over to Mack. Gains the blue line, but they come in offsides. A big hello to my loving wife, Miss Sarah, along with her lovely kids and my stepkids. Landon and Kylie Ann, they are tuned in from the friendly confines. of Riverbrook. And I hope they're enjoying themselves in a nice, warm, cozy homestead. A break in the action. 11:08 to go in the opening frame. It's the Bugs 1. The Jacks nothing. This is Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs.
Welcome back into George's Pond at Hirsch Coliseum. Play back underway up the middle now. Just lunged at there by Mitchell. That's Trevor Mitchell. Now intercepted. Max got it. Gotinski a drive. Same main rebound chance. Kicked out of trouble there. That might have got off the shaft of the stick of Orozco. Now Austin has it. He'll now wedge it into that far corner there for Mack. Battling for it. Getting help there by Goldie. 10:35 to go here in the first. 1-0 lead for Bugs Hockey. And now back the other way. Here comes Mansfield. He's outnumbered. He'll drop it back to nobody. Played back out to center, and now Wojciechowski will whip it back into the Bug zone. Slowed down there by Buschler, who has been under a storm of shots early in this game, rather. With 10:16 remaining here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period, Shreveport 1, Odessa nothing. Face off far circle. Face off battle at. Tied up. One there by the Bugs. Along to the far corner, Haru. We're wagon wheeled up ahead there to Vitali. Vitali dropped off and just shoveled in there by Lavassier. Along to the far corner. Nudged back up top. Haru hammers one toward the net. And a right pad save made there by Orozco. Lavassier was in front looking for the tip drill. Along to the far side. Here comes Finn. He gets bumped off the puck. That's a good job there by Zarski. Defensively for the Bugs. Off the stick of Vitali. Played back out to center. The line of Sutton, Murray, Lavassier, and Vitali. It is Sutton, Murray sandwiched in with a French connection. Off the near side, Arneson's pass broken up there by Vitali, and or rather Volkema. Volkema now will throw it off the far side boards, but he cannot dump it in. Played back in, nears Ryan Kelly. He'll work it in. Miller grabs the puck along to the far side there to Zarski. Now far circle, can held in there by Odessa. And now through the slot, right pad save made there by Buschler. That was a shot from the slot there by Hoyard. Back the other way, little space, here comes Miller. Near circle, snaps one toward the net. Blocker save made there by Orozco. Played back out to center. Miller had a little space with that one as Park has it, and he'll love tap this baby in. Along to the end boards, Miller tries to chase after, thrown in front, quick shot. Oh, that was a missile there by Steele, and I don't think Orozco saw it, but he got a glove on it. And now played up ahead there to Skillstad. Off the stick and spun into the Mudbug zone there by Purdian. As Park will settle it down there and drop it back to Sushinsky. Maxim Sushinsky from Bobrusk, Belarus. To the near side there to Park. Off the skate of Burke, and he'll bang it into the Jack zone, slowed down there by Orozco. Along to the far side, cross ice up the middle, taken there by Hughes, dropped off there to Armijo, but he comes in offsides. Lots of credit goes to our Mudbugs athletic trainer, Ms. Amy Baker, for all the patient and hard work she had to do with Simo Bushler's lower body injury, and there was a lot of work, a lot of treatments, a lot of discoveries, and, of course, lots of progress along the way, a little longer than they expected, but he is absolutely 110% healthy. Boy, he was like a kid at a candy store getting ready for tonight's game. He even spoke with me, and most goalies don't really talk on game days, and he was very social, very relaxed with his pregame routine. Now taken away, Mudbugs have it through the slot. That was a shot there by Gotinski, and it was bodied away there by Orozco. Danziger a drive, and it's gloved down there by Orozco. Mudbugs starting to get more opportunities here with 7:45 remaining here in the opening frame. Faceoff will go in the near circle to the left, Orozco. We got some big groups here tonight. Play back, high slot, shot there by Fleet. That one flew toward the net, gloved down there by Orozco. This is a Halloween Oktoberfest theme night. We got a lot of witches. Got a couple of cheerleaders. Quick shot there by Fleet. Gets blocked off the far side boards. Banked up ahead. And nudged out of trouble there by Sushinski. Played back out to center. Got some skeletons. I think we see Jigsaw from the movie Saw. Thrown in front! That was a shot off the stick of Vitali. Left pad save. Got some cats, got Wonder Woman, got Batman in the house. We're not talking about Volkema. Now the near circle, here comes Morris to the near corner. Morris has it, thrown back up top. Haru's got it, spins one toward the net, save made there by Orozco, and their rebound is steered out of trouble there by Wojciechowski. Hard check there. Zarski closes up the lane on Mansfield, but he's able to mail the puck into the bug zone. Volkema has it over to Zarski, and he'll loft it in off the stick of Steele, or rather Miller, and it goes in deep into the Jack zone. 6.5 remaining here in the first. Finn's got it. Finn kind of gets hip-checked a little bit now, taken away. Loose puck all the way down. It's going to be taken there by Nickel in deep into the Jack zone. Nichols got it, near circle. He waits. He'll now drop it in deep there for Steele. Steele now will slide it up ahead to the left point there to Austin. His shot gets blocked and ricocheted back out to center. Now to the left side. Shot there by Marshall. Deflects off the stick of Burke and into the protective netting. A break in the action. Mudbugs Hockey tonight brought to you by Fireplace Specialties. Fireplaces, gas logs, glass doors, wood stoves, inserts, mantles, and grills. They got it all. They're located at 8500 Box Road in Shreveport or logging on to fireplacespecialties.net. Be sure to get your tickets tomorrow night. The Mudbugs will conclude this two-game series against the Jacks. 7-Eleven puck drop. You can get your tickets now by giving us a call at 318-636-7094 or logging on to mudbugshockey.com. Tie up along the near corner to the right of Bushler. One out free, a wraparound chance smothered up there by Bushler as Austin, that was Josh Austin, drove the net. Now spun around, Gotinski trying to flip it out of the zone. Now able to win the battle along that far corner. That's Gotinski. Gotinski around the far side. He'll now just cue ball it back out to center, and it's taken back out there by Austin. Off the far side, now to the near side. Banked up ahead off the stick of Hoyer. It's going to be taken there by Park. Park's got it. He'll drop it off there to Danziger. He's got an assist tonight. Lavassier able to yank it back out to center. Far side off the heel of Arneson, taken away there by Danziger, and he'll just stash it back into the Jack zone. Big hello to the Danzigers tuned in tonight from Potomac, Maryland. Up the middle, dropped off now near circle. Shot there by Hughes. He fanned on it. Danziger able to take it up ahead and flip it back out to play, or back out to center. Lavassier and Murray in on pursuit. The puck is taken there by Skillstad. Skillstad up the middle, blocked off there by Sushinski. And the puck deflects out of play for a break in the action. 4:35 remaining here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period. Shreveport 1, Odessa nothing. Garrett Steele with the early tally at 4:57 in. He's got Chelsea, Michigan rocking. Garrett Steele in his fourth season as a Mudbug. And this will be his final season. So, you know, as they say, make it count. And we know he will as the second-year captain. Now behind the Jacks net, Volkema's got it. Volkema now got bodied off the puck. And now along to the far side, lugged up ahead. Here's Mansfield, gains the blue line. Left circle shot is redirected wide. Now behind the net, that's Fleet. He'll flip it up ahead. Now far side, flanked down there by Trevor Mitchell. He came out of the zone, and they'll come all the way back, and now we got a whistle. Not sure why there was a whistle. I thought Odessa was able to touch up. Looked like a hand pass on the Bucks. That's a little odd. That was the signal. Got a good crew tonight. Cameron Giancarlo, your lead referee. Odin Nelson, of course, the always lovable Brad Sotak is our Shreveport local and official linesman. Kissed off the near side window there by Zarski after the initial faceoff win for the Bugs. Goes all the way down for icing yet again on Bugs hockey. Mudbugs will be on the road next weekend as they will take on the Amarillo Wranglers next Friday and Saturday night from the Amarillo Civic Center. We'll have all the action live from that venue. I'll be on the call at 6:50 from Amarillo next Friday and Saturday night. Should be lots of fun. As Wojciechowski able to rake it back into the Bug zone. Far side, Zarski's got it. We got a whistle. And we got a penalty coming up. This one, I believe, is going to... This one's going to go against Liam Fleet, the seventh D-man this evening. And it's a roughing infraction. Second power play of the night for Odessa. First choice personnel penalty kill. We'll get back to work. .339 remaining here in the opening period, brought to you by Generational Financial Advisors. Bugs 1, Jacks nothing. Faceoff won there by Odessa. Played across Purdian. Back up top to Stacy. He'll go around the horn. Back to Stacy. Stacy's got it to Purdian. Top of the near circle. He'll wait. He'll glide back. Relay it back on over to Stacy. Across he goes. Quick shot blocked in front there by Danziger. Now near circle mishandled there by Purdian. And can the Mudbugs clear? They can. Right back out to center. That's a good stick there by Volkema. Big hello to the Volkemas. Tune in tonight from Vancouver, Washington. Purdian works it in from the high slot. Good stick there by Danziger, and now taken there by Gotinski. He'll come around the right side. He's working into the near corner, and he's just going to kill off some more precious seconds. Oh, he looked like he got slashed at along the back as he's sitting on the puck now, getting roughed up by a couple of jacks. Killing off some more precious seconds. And now Zarski going to glide all the way back, kill off some more seconds, and he'll be able to spitfire this baby all the way down. We're down to 55 seconds remaining on Fleet's roughing infraction. 2:30 remaining in the first, 1-0 in favor of the Bucks. Here comes Hughes. Good stick there by Vitali, and he'll zip it all the way down. This is Jason Soupy Campbell's baby. The penalty kill unit has been good for years, and he is one of the reasons for that success. As Gavin Morgan, former associate head coach, would say, the biggest reason for all that success. Gavin Morgan has gone on to say that it just feels like Coach Soupy's on the ice. He has so much of an effect on that PK unit. 15 seconds remain now as Fleet ready to get out of the box. Along to the far side, coming in. Quick snapper toward the net. Left pad save made there by Buechler on a shot there from the far side by Hughes. Now to the right point. Penalty coming up to an end. Quick shot toward the net. Tied up puck, and the puck is now sliced all the way down there by Goldie. Jack's 0 for 2 on the man advantage. 90 seconds remain on the Generational Financial Advisors first period. Taking their time behind the net there as Arneson wants to get set up. He'll go to the left side, and he'll bank it up there to Finn. Finn now on over off the stick, kicked around. That was a good job there by William Marshall as he threw it toward the net. It was paddled away there by Buechler. Off the near side boards, banked right all the way back into the bug zone. Off to the far side, kicked around there by Finn less than a minute to go in the opening frame. It's been kind of an up and down opening period for the Bugs. But they have a 1-0 lead as now Nickel 3-on-2. Here he comes to the right side there to Danziger. A drive, it went wide behind the net. Now Nickel has it. Far circle, we got a whistle. The net's off its mooring. And this faceoff will stay deep in the Jack zone. Stick around for the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy first intermission show. Lots of fun coming up. Faceoff will stay deep in the Odessa territory. Goldie to take the draw. Faceoff battle that tied up one there by the Jacks. Off to the near side. Goods stick there by Finn. Just a knife it back out into the bug zone. Now through the middle. Uh-oh, a turnover. And now it's taken a 2-on-1. Here comes Hoyer to cross. Thrown in front. Good stick there by Buechler to knock it out of trouble. Now Haru slides it up ahead there to Gotinski back out to center. 15 seconds to go. Look, someone got their stick caught up there. Now thrown back into the bug zone. Haru able just to ladle it all the way down into the Jack zone. Now to the near circle it goes. As the puck is, uh-oh, hard hitting going on now in front of Arosa. There was a hard hit behind that Jack's net. Odessa wanted a penalty as the buzzer sounds. So things get testy at the end of this opening period, and I believe it is Blake Arneson who is shaken up, and Amy Baker might have to go look at him. Odessa does not have a trainer on hand from what I've seen. And that scuffle is broken up, and we'll see if we get penalties at the 20th minute marker as Steele's got to go in, get a few words from Mr. Giancarlo. Nichols now looks like he's a bit worked up, and I think they might have equaling minors if my hunch is correct. We'll sort it out once we get the second period started. Stick around for the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy first intermission show. It's the Bugs 1, the Jacks nothing, thanks to Garrett Steele's third goal of the season. This is Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs!
As a business owner, you know it's important to stay ahead of your competition to succeed. One dishonest employee providing poor customer service can send your business to the penalty box. DeFatta & Associates has over 20 years of investigative experience that can help you monitor your employees and investigate losses that may be keeping you from reaching your goals. Whether you need GPS tracking, investigative shopping, integrity testing, or you're experiencing losses caused by theft, DeFatta & Associates can help. Give them a call at 318-635-9944 or check out their website at DeFattaPI.com for more information. The Robertson Cup champion Shreveport Mudbugs know big goals lead to big wins. That's why State Farm agent Ben Tolis and his State Farm team are here to help you score a big goal with your home and auto insurance. It's a great call that saves you time and money. So go score the winning goal and score savings by combining your home and auto. It's just another way we're here to help your life go right. Call State Farm agent Ben Tolis today at 318-688-1522. That's 318-688-1522.
Welcome back into the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show. A special treat with us, a couple of Mudbug corporate partners, but dear friends of the Mudbugs organization, the Team Solon Foundation, and Ronnie and Bridget Peterson. Not only are they part of the Team Solon Foundation, they're billet families, they're game ice officials, and we'll get to more of that. But first, with the Team Solon Foundation, just talk about how this all got started, Ronnie.
Well, shortly after Solon passed in early 2019, we wanted to do something to honor his memory and also help the local hockey community. So we started the charity of Team Solon Foundation to help pay for kids in the local area to start playing hockey.
And talk about the big event that really kind of, I think we launched it, so to speak, was that deck hockey tournament last year. It seemed like you guys raised a lot of money, and obviously for a great cause.
Yes, the deck hockey tournament in 2019 was our biggest event and really our first event, and we're overwhelmed with the community support that we have gotten. Had a lot of great corporate sponsors in that and raised a lot more money than we ever thought was possible, which has translated into more kids playing hockey than we thought we were going to have.
And you know, we have Bridget with us as well, and I wanted you to talk about the board, because I mean there's more than just you two that have done an outstanding job putting their hours of work in.
Yeah, we have Charlie Dew, who's been longtime family friends with us. Solon, she's an aunt to Solon, and you know, she's our treasurer. We came up with this idea with her, and then we added Christy Lang, who was the most recent member, and then our last member is Stephen McNeil, kind of like another uncle to Solon. Put all of our ideas together and just kind of run with them.
I wanted to ask you about this year, because you weren't able to do the deck hockey tournament due to COVID. Were you able to kind of find ways to substitute that, and what'd you guys do?
Yeah, a lot of people that had pre-registered, because it was heartbreaking to not have the tournament, but we've done shirts that should be in anytime now, and then we're doing some hoodie orders and just kind of doing a few things here and there. But we have a good deal.
What's been the overall response in trying to get help for kids that need, you know, that need help and that you're trying to help for hockey? What's been the overall response?
Well, we've had, as far as taking in donations. We've had incredible support, even in the time of COVID when we hadn't been able to do much as far as taking in donations and getting money to be able to help kids. The hardest part that we're having right now is just getting our name out there so people know that this is available. That's why we're partnering with the Mudbugs this year. Got our name on the Dasher boards. We really appreciate you helping us getting our name out there so people know that these scholarships are available so they can use them.
We're talking to Ronnie and Bridget Peterson from the Team Solon Foundation here on the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show. And Ronnie, I wanted to ask you, you know, away from the Team Solon Foundation, you guys decided to do some billeting, and I know that's something you guys have been wanting to do for a long time. You got one knucklehead, and you got one guy who's kind of grounded. You got Colin Doherty, who's bouncing off the walls, and you got Chris Hedden, who's probably the calm, cool cucumber. Is that the way it's been in the house between those two?
Oh, yeah, they're both really great young men, but they are polar opposites. You know, one who kind of keeps to himself and likes to just do his thing, and the other one who's a social butterfly and is always out going somewhere, doing something with somebody. But we couldn't be more blessed with the players that we have this year.
You know, Bridget, I wanted to ask you about the billet experience, being a mom, you know, to Miss Sammy, and you know, now she has two big brothers, and is she able to have that relationship with the two boys and Colin Doherty and Chris Hedden?
Oh yeah, she loves annoying them. Whenever they're outside, she wants to be right in the middle of them. If they have other guys over, it's like, leave them alone, give them their space, but they're great. They'll go outside and shoot hockey pucks with her. There's a neighborhood that comes over, and if they see them out there, they're out there showing them how to use the sticks and shoot the puck, and it's a great experience for all of us.
How's the cooking been for two you know, hockey players? I'm sure they have big appetites, and have you been able to introduce them to any kind of Louisiana cuisine?
We have. Colin is big into gumbo and jambalaya, but they tend to be grazers. They come to eat here, an hour later eat again, so it's kind of getting on that schedule. Been an adjustment, but it's been good.
And I wanted to ask both of you, and I'll start with Ronnie, was being a billet maybe one of the reasons why you scaled back being a game ice official? I've seen you there once in a while. I know Bridget stepped away from it, and I'll talk to Bridget in a minute about it, but was that the reason you guys kind of scaled back, because you guys wanted to maybe enjoy the game from a different perspective?
Well, I've always been kind of a on and off again off ice official, usually just helping out when they really needed somebody because somebody was out sick or on vacation or whatever. Usually I'm in the stands watching our daughter, so I wasn't able to always help. So that's kind of always my role. It's just a fill-in guy when they needed somebody.
The one who sorely missed, and I'm not going to lie, is every time I look down at every home game, I always used to seeing Bridget. I mean, probably since day one, since we started here in the North American Hockey League. And probably the most I guess comical thing is when you're frantically running towards the goal judge, and seemingly you've never gotten injured. But do you miss it, or is that something that you made that decision? Like, look, I do want to step down this year. I want to enjoy the game from a different perspective. I'm a billet mom. What kind of went into the decision?
It was a hard decision to make. I loved it. It was a part of the game that I didn't know until the bugs came back. But it was a decision that took a long time to consider, weighed my options. But I needed to scale back. I'm also going to school full time. So between that and with COVID happening and never knowing if my daughter was going to be in school, out of school, and we just wanted to enjoy the game from a different side again, be a fan again.
Before I let you guys go, what is the easiest way for somebody to reach out to you? I've been able to plug the Facebook page, and I know that's probably the best outlet.
Yes, right now the best outlet is just message us on the Facebook page, just Team Solon Foundation on Facebook. Currently, I have purchased teamsolon.com, and we are working on a website. Don't know when that'll be live yet, but it's in the works. But the Facebook page is the best way to get a hold of us.
Is there anything you wanted to add, Bridget, before I let you guys go? I really appreciate the time.
I just want to thank the Bugs for everything they've done. You know, Tommy and Scott Musket and even Soupy have been great in our lives. They were great in Solon's life. And without them, Team Solon might not be as great as it is. So.
Well, thanks for the time, and we appreciate the partnership, and enjoy the rest of the season.
Well, thank you, Chet Yoder.
We'll have more after these messages here on the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show. You're listening to Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs!
Sterling Dental Center is a proud partner of the Shreveport Mudbugs. I'm Dr. Emil Janu, and my experienced staff and I will handle all your dental needs, from routine cleanings, x-rays, cavities, toothaches, and more, with the best and safest treatment out there. We are a family here at Sterling Dental Center, and we treat our patients like family. We welcome many forms of insurance. Come get your next dental appointment at Sterling Dental Center in Shreveport by calling 318-688-1040 or logging on to sterlingdentalshreveport.com.
Mud Bug fans and now just off the ice. We got a really exciting game, and I'm going to warn you right now. I'm going to warn you right now. This game is going to be disgusting. Yes, it is. We're going to have a little burp off with three crazy Mud Bug fans. You guys are now, oh man, a lot of weight involved on this one. A lot of pride involved. Out of you three, we need to figure out who is the best burper at George's Pond here tonight. How we're going to do that, you guys are going to chug your beer, and whenever you're ready, you're going to let one out. Whoever has the loudest burp wins. This crowd will either go crazy or throw up. What's your name?
Tyler.
Tyler is here. Tyler, you are going first. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Tyler, he is, oh man, I can feel this burp coming already. He's down in that Coors Light. This sucker is going to be loud and proud, and kids will cheer and scream. Let's hear that burp. Wow! Got a little extra going on there. What's your name? Walter is here. Walter, you are up, my friend. Walter, that was pretty fast. You win the race now. Let's hear that burp.
Welcome back into George's Pond at Hirsch Coliseum. A 1-0 Mudbugs lead thanks to Garrett Steele, able to redirect home his third of the year from Burke and Danziger at 4:57 of the first. But at the end of the first, there were penalties that ensued, and Odessa is going to have a power play out of this because Dane Hoyard got tagged for roughing, but Logan Haru got a double minor for roughing. And I think it was the hit after or behind the net at the, well, as the buzzer sounded, which tagged Haru another 2 minutes. So Logan Haru not happy with himself. And Garrett Steele looks like he got wrong information at the end of the first period. And he's trying to get some clarification on what we talked about 20 minutes ago. Now, Garrett Steele can be one of the most level-headed captains you will ever come across. And that is about as pleasant of a conversation as I've seen a captain have with the lead official. Mudbugs will go on the first-choice personnel penalty kill for the third time this evening. And as good as it has been, it does get a little tiresome when you are back on being a man down. Mudbugs will skate from right to left here in the second period. The DeFatta and Associates LLC second. Dropped and won there by Volkma. Park takes his time, and he'll muscle it all the way down. Good start to the opening period for the Bugs. Now worked up the middle. That's Wojciechowski off the stick of Hughes. It goes into the near corner. Park now able to swivel it. Takes a weird bounce. That was a shot there by Wojciechowski. Got deflected off the near corner. Back out to center. Now played there by Hughes. Hughes to the far side. Taken there by Bajer. Bajer far half wall. He'll now knock it into the far corner. Kelly's got it behind the Bugs net. And now he goes to the near corner. Thrown back to the right point there to Mansfield. Across. Touched up cross. Quick shot there by Wojciechowski. Blocked in front. And the puck is shuffled all the way down. Good job there by Danziger. Or check that. That was Park. A lot of big bodies on that blue line. Now up the middle. That's Wojciechowski along to the far side. Working around the far corner. A little space now. To the near corner he goes. That's good. Played back up top now to Stacey. Stacey now has it to the point. He'll go to the left point there to Purdy. And 45 seconds remaining on the double minor to Haru. To the left point it goes. Now walk on the line. Toward the net. And it hit off the stick of, I believe that was Armijo. And it goes to the far corner. Mudbug's able to spill it all the way down. Now up the middle. Purdian works it in. Off the stick, a little space. Fanned on the shot there was good. The net comes off its mooring, and we get a break in the action. 20 seconds remaining on this power play for Odessa. Their third of the evening. Far circle, faceoff one there by the Jacks. Play to the left point. Here's Stacey. Goes across there to Boak. Boak kicks it around. Now to the right point. Stacey toward the net. Blocked off the stick of Nickel. Goes into the near corner. Penalty not over. Now behind the net. Little space. Turnaround shot. He winged it wide. That was a shot there by Good. Penalty almost over. And it is. So we're back to 5-on-5 hockey. Haru still in the box. Now from the high slot. Blocked toward the net. Oh, that was fanned on. That's a good stick there by Nickel. He tied up Purdy and stick coming toward the net looking for a scoring opportunity. Now off the stick of Purdy and couldn't handle it cleanly. Austin to the near corner. To the near side it goes. And Burke able to pop it back out to center. Off the far side, taken there by Purdy and 2-on-1 if they hurry. Thrown across now to the near half wall. Mudbug's able to regroup. Good stick there by Burke. To block the lanes. Mudbugs have done a great job at that so far this evening. Murray watches it go into the near corner, getting help there by Danziger to the near side there to Burke. He'll loft it up ahead there to Vitali. Vitali now will just sweep it in. It goes on net, and the Frenchman wants to give Arozzo a little snow shower as we are 2:50 into the second. Big hello to the Murray family. Tune in tonight from Rochester Hills, Michigan. Glad to have them with us. Sutton Murray, one of our young talents. Oh, boy, Coach Soupy fell in love with him early in training camp, and he is still in love with that young man. A lot of potential to be really a top-flight center for Shreveport. Off the near side window, back into the Bug zone. Into the near corner, Zarski. Up ahead there to Morris. He works it in to the Odessa zone, and it's now taken back out there by Skillstad. He'll now slap it up ahead there to Kelly across. That's a good stick tie up there by Morris along to the far side. That was Mansfield trying to redirect it home. Well, the Mudbugs have just been on their heels a lot tonight. And now taken back out there to and intercepted there by Miller. Miller can't clear. And now taken there by Bajor. Kicked it around now. Far half wall. Hard check play to the left point. Handle there. Skillstead toward the net. And an off the stick of Kelly in front. That one just went just wide of Bushler's cage. Far side. Fleet up ahead. And it's taken there by Miller. Miller now will come across. Two on two. And now he'll work it in and he'll just be able to barrel it in deep into the Odessa zone. Taken away there by Steele. Thrown across off the stick of Burke into the far corner. Taken there through the slot. Steele through the slot. He was looking for another. And a shot toward the net gets blocked in front there by Skillstad. As we are 4:20 into the Generational Financial Advisors second period. 1-0 lead for the Bugs. Second period brought to you by DeFatta and Associates, Investigative and Risk Analysis Services, Personal Matters, Child Custody Cases, Internal Theft Problems within your business. Just call our main man, Jerry DeFatta, at 318-635-9944 to talk about your case or log on to DeFattaPI.com. Faceoff one there by the Bucks. Park toward the net as it got blocked into the near corner. Held in there. Sushinski has it. He'll now level it in deep there for Burke. Burke now trying to grab it down low, getting help there by Nickel. Trying to shake it off the walls. Still grinding it out there is Burke. And takes a hard hit into the near corner. Good help there by Nickel. Boy, this is just grinding work down low for the Bugs. Trying to wear out that Jack's blue line, 5 minutes gone by, one out free now there by Josh Austin. Still got some tugging going around in the near corner away from the puck. Now along to the far circle. Good stick there by Park defensively to knock it out of the possession of Kelly to the near side. Up ahead there to Burke. Burke has it. Burke now will have it, and he'll just dump it in to the Odessa zone along to the near side. Taken there by Hughes. Hughes now shakes it up ahead. There to Good. Good now. Thrown toward the net. That was a no-look shot, and it whistled wide. And, boy, that one almost caught Bushler off guard. Into the near corner now. Austin battling for it. Into the near circle. Played back to the right point. Taken away. Oh, hard check as Lavassier got knocked off the puck. And looked like the Mudbugs were looking for an interference call. Is that one got hobbled toward the net, and it's covered up there by Arozzo for a break in the action. Almost 6 minutes gone by here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period. I'm Chet Yoder coming to you live from George's Pond and Hirsch Coliseum. The score is as follows. The Bugs won, the Jacks nothing, thanks to Garrett Steele's third of the season, 4:57 into this contest. Face off near circle, deep in the Jack zone, tied up. It was won there by Goldie, but taken away there by Purdian. He'll work it in, dropped off to the left point, thrown across. Good stick there by Haru to break it up. Haru now thrown up ahead there to Mack. Mack too far there for Gotinski. And now Gotinski takes a hard hit behind the cage. Now here's Mack. Mack thrown. Gotinski a drive. And oh, that's a shovel toward the net and a glove save. A bread basket kind of save there by Arozzo, who got handcuffed, but he's able to keep it out. Boy, Gotinski wants more of those opportunities in tight. As we saw what he could do with the puck as he scored a pair last Saturday. With a good snapper. Now that one rolls toward the net. Shot toward the net there by Murray. Oh, and a save made there by Arozzo. Boy, Halloween right around the corner. Halloween-themed weekend. Thinking about all the favorite candies. We got trick-or-treating going on in the concourse both nights. So our kids can get an early head start on those candy bags that have a tendency to fill up quite fast. Well, that's one of my favorites, Halloween. Because it just feels like it becomes a whole month filled full of candy. As the puck is iced all the way down. The Chet Yoder diet plan does take a hit, though, as far as all those goodies that come into the goodie bags. I love my Milky Way. I'm a big black licorice fan. Love the Skittles, Twizzlers. What's your favorite Halloween candy? You can go and message me or message the Bugs Twitter page, and I'll recite it on the air. I'm forgetting a lot. Reese's is a big favorite. I'm not a big peanut butter guy, though. I'm one of the rare parties that does not like peanut butter. Lavassier to the far half wall there for Murray. He's going to slow it down. Lavassier back up top. Danziger toward the net. It gets blocked. Now play to the left point. Austin, a drive. It went wide. Far corner, Vitali. Cannot work it in. Now Sushinski toward the net, and that one just kind of checkered wide of the net. Now from the high slot, Austin's going to grab it. He'll now just knock it into the far corner there for Lavassier. Toward the net, save made. Rebound chance. That was a kind of an awkward drive as Vitali lost a handle on that puck, but Arozzo kept it out. Now off the stick of Volkema, and it goes right back into the Odessa zone. Puck now off the stick of Finn. Looks like it's an icing, and it is on the Jacks. A big hello to the Eric Vitali family. Tune in tonight from Markham, Ontario. Of course, we know Markham, the homestead of Austin Brimmer, Robertson Cup championship winning forward. We miss that guy. I have not asked Vitali if he knows Brimmer. I'm sure the two might have come across paths. It's hard to miss Brimmer. He's a freak of nature. 2-on-2. Here come the Jacks back into the Bug zone toward the net. That one got blocked. It was a shot there by Marshall. Off the stick now of Morris. Back out to center. Nudged around. A chance here for Miller. Thrown back to Miller. Oh, Volkema had it on a busted play, and it was just mishandled. That was a good stick tie up there, rather, by Kelly. Now back the other way. Good stick there by Danziger. Into the near corner along the back check. Now worked out there by Haru. 8 minutes gone by here in the second. Hard check as Haru goes hard into the boards. Now behind the Bugs net. 11:50 remaining here in the second. Danziger to the near side there to Haru. Back out to center. All the way down for icing on Bugs Hockey. If you want to celebrate your next birthday party, you can. Right here at George's Pond, private ice time, private party packages are available. Give us a call at 318-636-7094 and ask for the very lovely Miss Lauren. She'll take care of you. Celebrate your next birthday party at George's Pond and Hirsch Coliseum. Taken away there by Odessa. Far corner, centering feed taken there. Kelly toward the net, didn't get much on it. Now to the near corner it goes. Right back up top to the right point. Shot off the heel of Miller and off the far side boards. Thought that puck came out. It didn't. It was held in there by Arneson, and now we got a whistle. Looks like the board got lodged out, and into the suite it went. We got to take a break in the action, and we got a board to possibly fix. 11:14 remaining in the second. Shreveport 1, Odessa nothing. This is Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
Best employee providing poor customer service can send your business to the penalty box. DeFatta and Associates has over 20 years of investigative experience that can help you monitor employees and investigate losses that may be keeping you from reaching your goals. Whether you need GPS tracking, investigative shopping, integrity testing, or you're experiencing losses caused by theft, DeFatta and Associates can help. Give them a call at 318-635-9944 or check out their website at defattapi.com for more information.
Sterling Dental Center is a proud partner of the Shreveport Mudbugs. I'm Dr. Emil Janu, and my experienced staff and I will handle all your dental needs, from routine cleanings, x-rays, cavities, toothaches, and more, with the best and safest treatment out there. We are a family here at Sterling Dental Center, and we treat our patients like family. We welcome many forms of insurance. Come get your next dental appointment at Sterling Dental Center in Shreveport by calling 318-688-1040 or logging on to sterlingdentalshreveport.com.
Welcome back into George's Pond at Hirsch Coliseum. Honoring our hometown hero. It is a 1-0 Mudbugs lead. And our hometown sergeant getting a standing ovation from the Mudbug faithful, as always. ...11:14 remaining. Here in the second period. And that one, puck rolls toward the net. And it's stopped there by Buschler. Now behind the Bugs net, battling for it. And taken there by Park. And Park is able to brush it out of the zone, but that puck deflects out of play. With 10:59 remaining here in the second period. Bugs still on top, 1-0, thanks to Garrett Steele's third of the season. Mudbugs back on the road next weekend. They'll be in Amarillo next Friday and Saturday night. I miss the road trips. It's been a while since the Mudbugs have been away, since, of course, the trip to Minnesota. Mudbugs looking for a better road trip this time around. Face off to the left of Buschler. Face off one there by Odessa. Near side there to Vardy. That's Lemuel Vardy. He'll throw it in front. Taken there by Vardy. Vardy now will ring it in deep behind the Bugs net. Along to the far side now. Loose puck. Battle that. Oh, boy. Mack just sealed up Mansfield and checked him hard in the boards. Played back out to center. Loose puck now. Battling for it there is Gotinski in deep into the Jack zone. Now behind the net. Mack's got it. Mack now will rattle it back up top. Oh, a shot toward the net there by Fleet got blocked in front. And now behind the net, Kelly's got it around the far side of Mansfield. Loose puck now gathered in there to the right side there by Kelly, thrown across. And Odessa comes in offsides. Boy, they were playing well after that whistle with now 10:08 remaining here in the second. Faceoff looks like it's going to come right back out to center ice. Well, that's a break for the Mudbugs. Faceoff one there by Odessa. Goes right back in. Steele in on pursuit. He has it. Now along the end boards. Now played back out. And the puck taken away there by Burke. And Burke's going to grab it, and he'll brush it back into the near corner. Now 2-on-2 with a burst of speed. Along to the far side. Quick shot score. Boy, that is one Buschler wants back. And we are tied with 9:47 to go in the second. That's a snapper from Emerson Good from the far circle. And we are now even 1-1. Well, Buschler, who has been under duress most of the first, knows that that one, and he'll tell you that's one he wants to stop. As Odessa finds the equalizer. Emerson good. Looks like Josh Austin will get one of the helpers. And it is a 1-1 game. The Mudbugs now a little bit on their heels. Played back out now. Vitale battling for it. Oh, what a hard check as Vitale put Purdy in hard in the game. Off the near side boards, up ahead there to Marshall. Marshall near corner toward the net. Into the far side, Lavassier will lick it up ahead. Hard check there as Morris went down awkwardly. Near side there to Marshall. Marshall gains the blue line. He'll work it into the near corner. 8:50 remaining in the second. We're knotted up at one. And a right pad save made there by Arozzo. We're battling for it along the inboards. Miller turn around, and he couldn't get much on it. Got a stick tied up. And now Park's got to get back. Off the far side boards there to Volkema. Volkema now will just soccer it back there to Ryan Austin. Emerson Goods third from Hoyard. And Austin at 10:13 has evened up the game 1-1 into the near corner. Handled there by Skillstad. Now he'll kick it into that near corner as we got a scrum starting to ensue. And a near half wall shot toward the net there by Kelly went wide. Held in there by Arneson from the left point.